The history of horses begins 55 million years ago. In fact, the horse, as known by man today, is just a small surviving fraction of the equidae family. Horses used to be all shapes and sizes, some the size of modern horses, and some no larger than a small dog. The closest known relative to today's equines is the 11 million year old Dinohippus. Interestingly enough, the horse, which vastly evolved in North America, became extinct to its homeland as a victim of overhunting and climate change, and survived only among the herds that migrated to Eurasia and Africa. The first suggested domestication of horses was found among the archaeological dig at Krasny Yar in Russia. Evidence points to corrals where horses would have been maintained as farm animals for their meat and the mare's milk. These inhabitants also utilized the manure as a source of insulation for the roofs of their houses. The first evidence of using horses for their ability to work was found in eastern Russia and Kazakhstan, where recovered chariot equipment dates back to 2000 BCE, and it is thought that by 1500 BCE, horseback riding was a common means of transportation in Afghanistan and Kazakhstan. You can say the first hunt can be dated back to 2,600 years ago, when horses were trained to work side by side with other hunting animals such as cheetahs, hawks, and dogs to chase down a kill during the royal lion hunts. It was not until the 1700s when fox hunting became a sport for sport's sake. British aristocrats would lead their horses and a large pack of hounds after the trail of a fox through fields, woods, and streams until they finally came upon their prey. Before the 1800s, fox hunting pretty much consisted of running through fields and across streams. After the introduction of the enclosure acts in England, riders suddenly needed horses that could clear fences and rock walls while still maintaining the speed and endurance needed to follow the hounds when they were on a fox's trail. The introduction of these obstacles was the foundation for a new sport, cross-country races. While many riders took to this new experience, spectators were rare and far between because of the limited view of the course. Riders would take off at the start of the race and within seconds be out of view of the spectators. Modernly, cross-country riders and their horses are dispersedly started and each timed individually. The rider and the horse with the fastest time wins the race. This way of managing the participants allows the spectators to stand in one spot and see each horse and rider as they come to the part of the course where the spectator is standing. Another solution to pleasing the spectators called for the introduction of lepping in 1869. It was a new sport where teams of horse and rider compete against other pairs to go through an obstacle course of jumps in a single arena. While women were allowed to ride horses, they were not permitted to compete against men and had their own side saddle divisions. Lepping was perhaps the first stages of show jumping as you see it at the Olympics. Stadium jumping today consists of three types of jumping. Hunters is a competition based on the conformation and skill of the horse, as the rider guides it around a simple course of lines, often in a figure eight pattern. Equitation is when both the rider and the horse are judged based on the rider's position, overall communication, and the smoothness of their trip through a course with more turns and jumps than in a hunter ring. The third and most well-known horse jumping competition is simply called jumpers. This category is a purely objective competition where the horse and rider with the fastest time and fewest faults wins the class. Grand Prix, the Olympic level jumping, falls under this style. The first gold medal the United States won in the show jumping division of the Olympics was awarded to William Steincross and his horse Snowbound at the 1968 Olympics hosted in Mexico City. It was not until 16 years later that the U.S. won the team medal. The winning team was comprised of Joseph Vargas aboard Touch of Class, Conrad Holmfeld on Abdullah, Leslie Howard on her horse Albany, and Melanie Smith atop Calypso. This team not only won the gold for the United States, but they did it on home soil, something only a handful of other teams were able to accomplish. This year, with a team comprised of no less than the best riders in the country aboard some of the most athletic horses in the world, the United States is returning to the Olympics with hopes of achieving the show jumping team gold for the third consecutive Summer Olympics and the fourth time in United States history. But until then, equestrian fans and horseback riders around the world wait in anticipation to watch their home teams compete among the best in the world for a chance to write their names down in history.